Very welcome to video number 257. This is lecture number 5, and today I am going to discuss the Rural Support Programs Network of Pakistan. Let me start with a very serious and important question regarding unequal distribution of wealth and consumption of resources. If you investigate the global statistics, it is evident that 20% of the world population consumes 80% of global resources, whereas the poorest 20% only account for 1.3% of global consumption. The centerpiece of a policy framework for poverty alleviation has to be the mobilization of the poor in order to enable them to participate directly in the decisions that affect their lives and prospects. The available literature points out that there are two pillars of the state, that is the administrative pillar and the political pillar. But there is the missing link, and that is that the socio-economic pillar is absent. None of the federal ministries, provincial and district departments or elected bodies have the capacity to engage all or overwhelming majority of people, especially the vulnerable and the poor, in planning, implementing and monitoring their own development agenda. Fostering of socio-economic pillar through social guidance cannot be undertaken by government departments or NGOs. It requires an institutional mechanism which has the resources of the government and flexibility of an NGO, such as Rural Support Program. Solution recommended by ISACPA: implementation strategy and institution building by governments of South Asia. Support financially and administratively the establishment of independent, non-governmental and national level support mechanism to catalyze formation of organizations. This is the definition given by Abraham Lincoln regarding democracy, that is, government of the people, by the people and for the people. We can also apply his thought here in Rural Support Program Network. So we can say of institution, by elected institution, for administrative institutions. Core function of rural support programs: fostering a three-tiered social mobilization network. So the first tier of social mobilization network is local support organizations. So there are 1,497 LSOs, and LSOs regarding to women, relating to women, are 466. Then there are village organizations, and the total number of village organizations is 20,814. And then we have community organizations, and the total number of community organizations in Pakistan is 409,883. Now it covers 7.1 million households, and that constitutes 48% of the total household, in which 44% are This is the holistic approach to social mobilization. So there is social organization, human resource development, credit and savings, technical assistance in natural resource management, development of physical infrastructure, linkages with government departments, local councils, NGOs, commercial and development agencies. Our network, Rural Support Program Network, and the outreach of rural support programs across Pakistan include Aga Khan Rural Support Program, Sarhad Rural Support Program, National Rural Support Program, Institute of Rural Management, Ghazi Barota, Tarakiyati Idara, Tardeep Rural Development Program, Punjab Rural Support Program, Balochistan Rural Support Program, Sindh Graduates Association, Sindh Rural Support Organization, Foundation for Integrated Development Action. So out of 148 districts, 145 districts have been covered in this, and the national outreach is available to 47.3 million people. Now this is how outreach works. Community organizations and women community organizations, then we have union councils, we have household membership, and local support organizations. And if you see, 145 out of 148 districts have been covered in it. They have been reached out, and this means that 47.3 million population has been outreached by this RSPN. A National Multidimensional Poverty Index, this is prepared by Planning Commission and UNDP, and it's complementary measure to consumption income based poverty estimates, measures deprivation in health, education and standard of living, built by using PSLM data sets, and it has been estimated for every 2 year period since 2004-05, and it can be disaggregated at the provincial and district levels. Multidimensional poverty index can be unfolded to see how people are poor. According to MPI, about 39% of the population are poor. They belong to poverty. Then there is another thing, and that is known as WISE. And WISE means water, that is potable drinking water. I stands for immunization, which is preventive healthcare. Then there is sanitation, and that consists of solid and liquid waste management, and education, which refers to primary education. So these make more than 70% of any provincial government budget, but still government struggles to achieve any or all of the above goals because the issue is too large and serious. But this can be achieved by taking bits of the issue and using three-tiered social mobilization model to undertake all of WISE in a holistic manner at Union Council level. WISE and Sustainable Development Goals. WISE also targets Sustainable Development Goal number 6, 3 and 4, which Pakistan missed in Millennium Development Goals. These are difficult to achieve on national scale, and these include immunization coverage up to 54%, literacy rate to be increased to 58%, sanitation 48%, sewerage 18%, and 40% for urban, 6% in rural. Access to safe and clean drinking water 56%, but this can be achieved by the social mobilization model at the Union Council level. What can social mobilization offer? Local support organizations become WISE implementers. RSPs act as donor and TA providers. TA in form of Android based baseline data collection and measuring evidence of progress. WISE creates demand for access through linkages to public services at the Union Council level and below. Additional activities that communities can undertake include malnutrition, basic rights and responsibilities as citizen, gender equality and empowerment, peace and conflict resolution. Lessons learned in WISE implementation. Donors and provincial governments have been struggling to improve WISE indicators for decades. Existing networks of the organized communities can show evidence-based results within 1 year. Results can be achieved across Pakistan and provinces. Strengthening of institutional networking, especially with land departments, is critical, and there should be positive response from all provinces. Additional activities that can be undertaken through organized communities, and they to target malnutrition, basic rights, and gender equality. Basic rights and responsibility as citizen. CNIC coverage should be given to maximum possible number of people, birth and death rate registration, voter registration, NICA registration, capacity building of office bearers and CRPs in human rights, participation in various forums and alliances at local and national level, participation in projects for increasing access to public services, for example, enrollment, immunization, nutrition, and etc. Participation regarding gender, 50% women household head in organized communities, women participation in making the household level micro investment plans and village development plans. Access, more than 50% women credit clients, women consultation at design stage in infrastructure projects, 50% participants in training. Peace and conflict resolution initiative, formation of peace committee at village level, inclusive planning involving sects and minorities, capacity building sessions for conflict identification and resolution amongst stakeholders, localized IEC material for awareness raising session on peace and stability, regular dialogues and engagement between local support organization and village organizations and local religious leaders, especially for girls education and immunization, etc. Ladies and gentlemen, if you haven't yet subscribed to this channel, kindly click on this red button and do not forget to click on the bell icon so that you can get notified about other videos that will be uploaded soon. For you people, I would like you people to share, like, and comment in the right comment in the comment section. I'll get back to you soon. Thank you very much for watching this video.